endangered sea turtles off the local coast. Western News 10 at 10 starts right now.
Preying on the kind-hearted, then robbing them blind. A local woman accused of using a baby as her decoy. Good evening. I'm Jim Payne.
I'm Martha Sagowski. Police say she's no mother of the year, and now the jig is up.
West 2's Craig Lucy is live in Sanford tonight, and Craig, sounds like she hit several houses there with the same plan.
Jim and Martha, there are at least four families in this neighborhood that have had jewelry stolen from them. This home behind me is one of them, and you can see right on the fence they have these warning signs for potential thieves. But police say this thief is a mother who would use her baby, and she would just walk right through the front door. With her head down, 20-year-old Megan Phillippe mustered up a brief denial.
I didn't do it.
Soft-spoken now, but her victims say the Phillippe they encountered was far more convincing.
First time I've ever seen it.
With a strategy Eddie Avila and several others fell for.
Door and I see a girl with a baby crying, suffocating, sweating, her eyes were back. She told me that the car was overheated and the baby needed some help.
Avila let Megan Phillippe in. They talked.
She asked me to hold the baby while she went to the bathroom.
When Phillippe left, police say she had stuffed her pockets with nearly $8,000 worth of jewelry. We showed Avila her arrest.
Yeah, that's her, man.
He says now it's personal.
Her birthday anniversary is gone. And my wife deserves it. And I'm going to make sure that she gets everything back.
Police say Phillippe's next victims were less than a mile from Avila's home.
She asked to use the bathroom. She went to the bathroom in the back.
If she couldn't find stuff to steal, investigators say Phillippe would stall and pretend to make a call.
I looked at both of my phones and there were no outgoing calls.
Her accusers say Phillippe was personable, kind.
And she asked, could I have some cookies? Because I had a cookie jar there. So I gave her some cookies. She ate some cookies and then she was thirsty.
Thirsty for more jewelry. We checked Megan Phillippe's record, and she has been arrested numerous times for theft and dealing in stolen property at local pawn shops. We asked police how the baby was doing. They said the baby is fine, and right now her grandmother is taking care of the baby for now. But the charges are just beginning to mount up for Megan. Reporting live in Sanford, Craig Lucy, West 2 News on CW18.
Two local counties now singing the Tarball Blues after beachgoers in Volusia County spotted trouble in the tide.
The tar in both counties is being collected and inspected. We have team coverage from the two possible trouble spots, starting with West 2's Gail Pascoe Brown in Cocoa Beach, followed by Amanda Ober in Ormond by the Sea.
Yeah, I'm here along Cocoa Beach. In fact, at the Cocoa Beach Pier, where people are truly enjoying the sun and the fun, just having all kinds of excitement. But bottom line, yesterday, Coast Guard officials, actually they were pollution investigators from Jacksonville, they're investigating reports of tar balls found along area beaches of Cocoa Beach as well as Cape Canaveral. Now, samples were taken yesterday. Those samples are on their way to a lab in Connecticut. We hopefully will find out in a week to 10 days exactly where those tar balls originated from. Right now, we do not know. I'm Gail Pascoe Brown along Cocoa Beach.
Some tar found here on the beach in Ormond by the Sea on Tuesday drew some Coast Guard inspectors on Wednesday. Now, the inspectors came down from Jacksonville. They spent about 20 minutes combing the sand at North Peninsula State Park, that is in Ormond by the Sea. They did not find any additional tar, and the Volusia County Beach Patrol tells us they're fairly confident this tar is not from the Gulf oil spill. They say it's a common occurrence to find tar in the sand here, and typically it comes from freighters that flush their bilges offshore. In Ormond by the Sea in Volusia County, Amanda Ober, West 2 News.
BP is now working to hook up a new oil collection vessel. The container is in place at the bottom of the Gulf, and it is expected to double the amount of oil that's being captured. Leaders say a relief well is also being drilled to plug the leak. BP thinks it will still be mid-August before that leak is completely stopped.
New tonight, a registered sex offender is accused of attacking a local woman who helps the homeless. Lake County deputies say 50-year-old Antonio Cardoza beat and raped the woman back in June. The victim routinely brings food and water to homeless people in a wooded camp near Florida Hospital Waterman. Cardoza lived in the woods and has served time for lewd and lascivious assault on a child. Confirmation tonight, carbon monoxide killed the local couple found dead on an anchored boat. The bodies of 50-year-old Howard Lumpton and his 48-year-old wife Sandra were found July 4th on their boat at Disappearing Island. Detectives say the two were running the generator on board. Residents of a local apartment complex want to know why they weren't told more about two heinous attacks on women.
Now, prosecutors say the suspect is so dangerous, he's now behind bars on no bond. Orlando police say last Friday, Fernandito Carpio forced his way into a 24-year-old woman's home at the Place at Millennia Apartments. Detectives say he raped her, cut her throat, and left her for dead. Residents at the complex say hours later they received a letter, but it only mentioned criminal activity. They say the note should have been more specific.
Well, I feel like we have the right to know, as residents living in the apartment complex, that dangerous things are occurring.
Carpio is also accused of attacking and choking a woman at the nearby Fountains apartment complex back in June.
Turtle trouble has detectives concerned on Cocoa Beach.
Now, police say they've discovered several decapitated sea turtles in recent days.
West 2's Dan Billow is live in Cape Canaveral, keeping lights low because it's nesting season. Dan, does anyone know why this is happening?
Well, the best theory, Martha, is that it's some sort of ghastly trophy or souvenir that's selling online. And we do have our light as dim as possible because this is where the sea turtles like to nest quite often, at the base of the grassy dunes, and the lights could scare them away. The troubles for nesting sea turtles are growing.
She has one tie. And then she
for longer than the world has seen civilization, sea turtles have been laying eggs on these beaches. They come at night. They lay about 110 eggs at a time, and they leave them to incubate in the warm sand. But the number of nests for loggerhead turtles is steadily declining. And so it was especially disturbing when two dead turtles, like this one, were discovered within the past week with their heads cut off. Two people witnessed the sickening act.
Someone came out, cut the head off, put it in a bucket, and walked off with it.
Police questioned a fisherman who admitted nothing but gave police the impression the heads could be sold online. Selling or possessing a sea turtle, or even part of one, is illegal. This nesting season has been difficult for turtles, with many cases of people interfering, often unintentionally. Turtle watchers counted more than 50 people with flashlights one recent night, along with 17 turtles, all within 1 mile of beach. Only one of the turtles made a nest. The lights frightened them away. And one well-meaning couple poured cool water on a nesting turtle because the sun was coming up.
And that immediately caused her to stop laying eggs, and she walked back into the ocean, not even covering up her nest. Those eggs probably won't survive because they weren't covered properly.
The law says you must stay 50 yards from a nesting sea turtle, and because of the declining numbers of nests in recent years, regulators are considering moving the loggerhead turtles from the threatened species list to the endangered list. We're live in Cape Canaveral. Dan Billow, West 2 News on CW18.
Advocates can keep feeding the homeless. They just can't do it in Orlando's iconic park.
A federal appeals court has put a stop to large homeless feedings at Lake Eola Park. The decision reverses a 2008 ruling by a federal judge who said the city's rules were unconstitutional. The city says it feels vindicated. The attorney for Food Not Bombs, a group that feeds the homeless, says it's willing to work things out.
I think there is definitely an open door for compromise. I think the number one priority of Food Not Bombs and the other people in the community who support them is to continue sharing food, to continue building relationships with homeless people that hopefully will bring them into other services and all of that.
Homeless advocates have 21 days to appeal the ruling.
New tonight, a local neighborhood is protesting against a series of gang arrests. Several dozen parents and relatives rallied in Daytona Beach tonight, then walked to city commission chambers to protest. Last week, police rounded up and hauled in more than 40 people. Detectives say they're members of a violent gang called the 819 Boys. But their family members say there's no evidence their loved ones are gangbangers.
You know what I mean? Now, they might have been out doing something wrong. I can't back that. But it's not no gang. No. If he can prove that it's a gang, he need to come out and put it on paper and show us where it's a gang.
Police say it's a long-running investigation with proof of gang activity. Kids may be to blame for a local condo fire. Flames destroyed one unit and damaged several others at the Hidden Ridge Condos off North Lake Boulevard in Altamont Springs. Investigators say two children were in the condo at the time that fire started. No one was injured.
West 2's 10 at 10 checking your weather right now with Chief Meteorologist Tony Manoffi in a really nice, quiet night out there.
Beautiful. I'll tell you what, we're going to crank up the heat tomorrow. We'll talk more about that in a second. Let me take it back outside. You're going to need that. The fan tomorrow, that's for sure. And the AC? Or a movie with mom and dad. How about that idea? All right, downtown Orlando, things are pretty quiet. Let's take a look now at the satellite and radar. We do have fair skies out there, onshore flow right now. Things are relatively quiet. We've lost the breeze tonight. Temperature's still pretty comfortable, though. 73 Kennedy Space Center, actually warmer towards the interior right now. Look at those winds. Fairly light along the coast, northeast to 2 through downtown Orlando, northeast at about 10. Daybreak temperatures tomorrow, 69 north and west, low 70s south and east. As we take a look now, what's going on here in the tropics? Hurricane hunters are down in the Gulf. We're going to talk more about what they're getting out of their reports tonight. Jim and Martha, straight ahead.
All right, Tony, thanks a lot. The trial of a local man accused of intentionally running down a woman because of her race could wrap up tomorrow. Prosecutors say Thomas Cosby hit Nikita Cato on her bike 2 years ago, then started screaming racial slurs. Today was the first time she's seen him since the attack.
Was he thinking about me? Do you remember how I look? Was he looking at me? So I just try to have no eye contact.
Cosby's attorney says his client is a paranoid schizophrenic. If convicted, he could face 35 years in jail.
A local teen may be tried as an adult in a librarian attack. Angel Rios Labrador is charged with attempted first-degree murder. Orange County deputies say the 17-year-old stabbed a librarian in the neck early Monday morning at the South Creek Library. The victim did not suffer life-threatening injuries.
The head of NASA is getting knocked.
Next to 10 is comments on Muslim relations that has angered